Why do some investors see property as a safe investment while seeing stock as just pieces of paper? Will your stock just disappear without warning one day? Hi guys, Stanley here. I'm the co-founder of the website valueinvestasia.com, where we bring you key research on stocks across Asia and the US. This video is part of our free investment course, and you can gain access to the whole course and its resources on the link below. Right, let's talk about stocks. What are we buying when we purchase a stock? Are we merely buying a stock ticker that just moves up and down every second? Or is a stock really a less safe investment compared to something like a property? To me, I feel this is a big misconception about stocks because a stock is much more than just a piece of paper. A stock is actually a part ownership of a company. This means that when we buy a stock, you're becoming a shareholder of a company behind that stock ticker. So if you have invested in a stock like Telekom Malaysia or Singapore Telecommunication, you have in fact turned into a shareholder of these companies. It means that you are entitled to a percentage of the profit that the company are generating. For example, if you have bought 1,000 shares of Amazon at $3,000, it means you have invested $3 million in the company. And at the end of last quarter, Amazon has about 500 million shares outstanding in the market. This means that if we see Amazon as a pie that is divided into 500 million slices, you own 1,000 slices of it. It means you are the rightful 0.0002% owner of Amazon. And Jeff Bezos actually worked for you. And as Amazon make about 11.6 billion last year, your share of the profit is about $2,320. This means that by buying a share, we are taking part of the growth and earnings of a company in the future. Your share will be worth something as long as Amazon is still in business. So if we compare the probability of, say, Amazon going bankrupt to a property that might be slowing decaying, which one is more likely? In fact, I feel that if Amazon is managed well, it can continue to do even better year after year without any additional investment from you. But a property requires constant maintenance to ensure that it keeps its value. So which investment is really likely to become worthless one day? For me, I'll choose the stock every single time. And it is no surprise that most of the world's richest people build and store their wealth in stocks. We can see Bill Gates or Warren Buffett or Jeff Bezos, Mark Zuckerberg or Jack Ma are all wealthy because of their stocks in their company. So it is important that we do not fear the stock market, but rather we just need to understand it. The stock market, as the name suggests, it's just a marketplace where buyer and seller comes to buy and sell companies. A simple illustration would be to see the stock exchange as the owner of this marketplace. So it is similar to, say, a night market. But instead of just letting vendors set up stalls to sell food, the stock market allows company to come and sell part of their company to the public. And like any market, there will be good and bad people within it. For example, we can easily find beggars or thieves or scammers and police around the night market. In the stock market, we can find the equivalent such as empty shell companies, shady management, market manipulators, and both the regulators and fraudsters all operating within it. As investors, we need to be aware of this and not fall trapped into these unethical operators. Next, we need to know there are two types of market within the stock market. The primary market and the secondary market. When we hear a company going for its initial public offering or IPO, it is the primary market that we are talking about. This means that the company is entering the stock market for the first time. In an IPO, the company is selling its share directly to the investors. In this example, the new company is seeking to list its shares on the stock exchange. And with the help of other intermediaries, it will prepare the company and promote it to the public. The public can then subscribe to its IPO, buying shares to the company directly at a fixed price. But once the IPO process is complete and the company is successfully listed on exchange, its stocks is free to trade based on the buyer and seller in the secondary market. So every time that we're checking the stock price of a stock, it is the secondary market that we're looking at. In this market, the company itself is no longer selling shares directly to investors. Instead, existing investors can sell shares through the stock market to other potential investors. This is typically done through a brokerage house, which acts as an intermediary for both the buyer and seller of the company. And so that is the secondary market that we're talking about. And as long as we understand the risks and how to avoid them in the stock market, there are many benefits in investing in stocks compared to other asset class. For one, the stock market gives us more flexibility as we can invest and cash out of the market with relative ease. Typically, we will be able to receive the cash of our investment within a few days of selling them. Compare that to properties or funds where it takes up to months before we can get back our money if we choose to sell them. And secondly, the stock market gives us the ability to invest globally with a click of our mouse. Every major exchange around the world has thousands of companies listed in them. And for a well-diversified portfolio, we are looking at just 15 to 30 companies to invest in. Therefore, investors have the luxury in choosing the best possible investment that suits their need and objectives. Moreover, investors can easily diversify across geographical markets and industry on the stock market. All we need to do is to buy companies exposed to different markets or industry. And as technology improves, the cost of investing in overseas market is getting lower and lower. Therefore, the stock market allows us to invest anywhere in the world at the comfort of our own home. What other advantage can you think of with regard to the stock market? Let me know in the comment section below. Remember, this is part of our free investment course series. You can just go to valueinvestasia.com/free course to gain access to the entire course and also download the learning materials as well. Anyway, that's it from me. I'll see you in class 3. Till we meet again, invest safely. Hi guys, thanks for watching the video. If you like it, please give us a like. And if you find it useful, I hope you share it as well. Remember to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button to get notified on our next video. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!